my class of 2022. Let's say it one more time. You ready? Saturday school, Saturday school, Saturday school. I'm going to miss y'all. All right, let's get this thing started. Will the color guard please come forward?
Johnson. I'm the assistant head of schools for the Senior Academy. These are my babies as much as they are yours. Except for that one. All right. So I want to do a little bit of house cleaning so this can run very smoothly. Please turn off all cell phones or put them on silent. No guests are allowed on the floor for any reason during the ceremony. You will be taken out. Photographs are from the seating areas only, where your seat is, where you can take pictures from. Students, when we ask you to get up by your program, make sure you grab the name on the back of your seat, because I don't want you to get the wrong diploma. With that said, I would like to introduce our head of schools, Dr. Sydney Brown. Please give it up.
Good evening, Madison Park. Good evening, Madison Park. Greetings and salutations, and welcome to Madison Park Technical Vocational High School's graduation for the class of 2022. This is one of the best classes ever. They faced a pandemic which the world has not seen in over 100 years. They've done a wonderful job. They've had a great prom. They're having a normal graduation. They have so many Skills USA victories. And we have two students graduating with a community college degree called Rocksmap from Bunker Hill Community College. Again, they're the best class ever. Their graduation rate, based on our numbers, is at 74%. With that said, that's an increase of 10% over the last 10 years.
To welcome our special guests. We have Dr. Linda McIntyre, Madison Park Superintendent of Schools, to my right. We have our valedictorian to my left, or my salutatorian. Also at this time, I would like to recognize our staff and faculty for what you've done to make sure that our students graduate. and graduate on time and be successful. Our parents, if you were saying that's so important, you brought them here thus far, and we want to thank you all as the parents would say. Our speaker for the evening is going to be our city councilor at large, Ms. Julia Mejia. I will read her bio. I've had a chance to introduce myself to her, and it's been a pleasure knowing her and knowing her passion for education. She supports Madison Park and what we're doing here. She was born in the Dominican Republic. Julia arrived in a neighborhood called Dorchester when she was 5 years old. She was raised by a single mother who was undocumented for most of her childhood. She was forced at an early age to speak on behalf of her mother and others who felt ignored by the very institutions that were supposed to serve them. She was driven for a lifelong pursuit of justice and equity. Councilor Mejia has created countless opportunities for others to step into their power and advocate for positive change as a community organizer. Following the 2019 election, it was a historic two-month recount. Julia won by one single vote. Seniors, your vote counts. So make sure you learn from her lesson. Became the first Afro-Latina to sit on the Boston City Council. Councilor Mejia is currently the chair of the Committee on Education, so she provides all the funds for this activity and most of the activities that we're trying to do. The Committee on Government Accountability, Transparency, and Accessibility, as well as the Committee on Labor, where you get a job, workforce, and economic development. Let's give her a round of applause before she comes up. Okay, you can say we changed our program back to where it is. Next, we have Dr. Linda McIntyre to bring greetings from DPS.
Good evening, everybody. But most importantly, good evening to the class of 2022. I'm going to ask you to stand so we can adore you. Stand just for a moment and let us adore you. Let us love you. Let us reward you with grace and with joy for your achievements. I come to you this evening on behalf of the Boston Public Schools. You may be seated. I share just one bright passage that you can take with you wherever you go. Sharpen your eyes, unlock your ears, listen and learn. You'll understand, minute by minute, hour by hour. Know and own your story, because that's your power. You guys have been, and ladies have been, nourished to flourish by everyone in this arena and those that are outside of it. Your parents, your teachers, your leaders, your community partners, your friends, and each other. You remember them. It's your journey to have, and this world is yours to change. Go in peace and bring about great promise. Class of 2022, we are proud of you and appreciate you and enjoy you this evening. Thank you.
first speaker for the evening will be our salutatorian, Miss Rachel Pamina. In hospitality management, diligence and focus are two words that come to mind when you hear her name or it's brought up. Every morning, she made the journey across town from East Boston to Madison Park, Technical Vocational High School, where she spent the entirety of her time as a leader in hospitality management and throughout the school. Since her freshman year, she showed discipline in the classroom and took as many opportunities and challenges as she could, also making the honor roll for each term and as a member of the National Honor Society. Additionally, Rachel has been an active member of both DECA and Shield USA since her sophomore year, and she was the first student selected to go out on co-op after the shutdown of COVID-19. This pandemic has hit the hospitality industry very hard. She was placed with J.P. Lynch and shined and excelled in her duties and set the tone for the future of our partnership. Overall, Rachel is an amazing young lady who was made by her family and her teachers extremely proud. We all look forward to hearing from her about her achievements in the future. Rachel, please come forward.
Thank you.
is a special student at Madison Park Technical Education High School. She is the only female student in the auto college program. She has excelled in the program as well. Throughout her high school career, she has earned many achievements and awards, such as high honors, cargo of the week, perfect attendance, and as a member of the National Honor Society. Rihanna's ability to multitask and to get the job done is evident in her advanced academic and vocational skills. During her time as a student at Madison Park Technical Vocational High School, Rihanna has maintained a 4.0 GPA. Her intellectual curiosity and diligent attitude drive her to maintain an exceptional work ethic. In addition to excelling in her academic education, Rihanna also puts forth great effort in her extracurricular activities. She has played an integral role as a student representative in the school hiring committee, as I mentioned earlier, as captain of the girls' varsity soccer team, and current manager of the girls' basketball team. Rihanna is the student vocational person of the year. After high school, Rihanna planned to attend community college to earn an associate degree in automotive technology. Upon completion of her college, she is looking forward to pursuing a career in auto technology. We look for great things from Rihanna. Rihanna, please come today.
My name is Brianna Valentina Dura, valedictorian of the now Madison Park Technical Vocational High School class of 2022. I am graduating here today as the only female student in the automotive technology program. A couple of years ago, I lost somebody who greatly impacted my life. Despite the loss, I was determined to keep moving forward. I had to do it for them, which gave me the strength and courage to also do it for myself. Throughout the last 4 years, I tried to study and do my best at all times. It is difficult to maintain focus, especially during the pandemic. I'm a hands-on person, and we lost a lot of hands-on learning. During the pandemic, teachers were saying that studying, although remote, will always help. That may work for an academic person, but it's not working being in a vocational high school. Hands-on learning, and it was very difficult to grasp. Reading about 15 cards is very different than actually working on cards. At Madison Park, unlike any other student in the city of Boston, not only do we juggle our academics and vocation, also sports, clubs, and other activities, not to mention our at-home responsibilities. We work hard to keep our grades up, keep our focus, and most importantly, keep our standards. Maintaining our grades allowed us to play sports, participate in opportunities like co-op, skills USA, and be recognized for our efforts. We strive for excellence, for greatness of whether we were in the shop, the classroom, the court, the field, knowing that we are enhancing our lives, preparing ourselves for after high school. Class of 2022, give yourself a pat on the back. I have a message for you all. Never stop working to achieve your dream. Regardless of what it is, seek out your future and keep working hard to achieve your goals. Class of 2022, we did it. We made it to graduation, and I'm truly proud of this moment for us all. We have endured a lot, and He's just defeated. We have proven our doubters wrong once again by being here across the stage. We fought, we learned, and we have one overwhelming year, with this year bringing one big challenge after another. As I mentioned earlier, coming back from quarantine, losing 2 years of vocational experience, a lot of uncertainty, we lost our biggest school spirit to see to a different job. I want to mention one of my biggest inspirations, Mr. Kevin Madison. Mr. McCaskill, before I even made it to Madison. Mr. McCaskill, the former executive director, was the biggest inspiration the school had. He brought joy to school every morning and always had a smile on his face. He always encouraged us to do our best. I want to thank him for always putting us students first, for treating us as adults, and also for just being there for us every step of the way. I also like to thank the following people. My parents and friends for the constant support throughout the years. Coach Montero for being there since day one. My teachers and counselors for always supporting us. Although it was a very long year, we did what we had to do to accomplish our goal of graduating. With effort comes success, and we make that effort today to cross this stage. And parents, do not judge our choices without understanding our reasons. Not every kid is going to want to go to college. So college isn't for everyone. Not only do we have our own opinions where we should go in life, we want to make our own decisions. And the only thing you can do is support and guide us where we want to go, regardless if you choose college, the industry, the military, or a particular passion. Your understanding and support will be greatly appreciated and valued. Now the time has come where we cross the stage and really become adults. My last advice to y'all is that there are harder paths to come to life. Take the lessons we've learned and live a life worth living. With that, congratulations, class of 2022!
We can even do better. We have two students I would like to introduce. They're earning associate degrees from Foster Hill Community College. That is big. So far, Madison Park is the only high school at Boston Public Schools to have students to graduate from Foster Hill. Foster Hill has a graduation rate of only 17%. So for them to be in high school, to then also get a high school diploma, I want both of them to stand as I call them today. The first one is, what about seniors? I've got the seniors. Come tell me what it is. Cameron Dixon. She's a health assistant student at Madison Park, Chandler Vocational High School. Enrolled in Rochester in the fall of her junior year, she successfully balanced her academic classes at Parker Hill as well as at Madison. As a health assistant student, Chantel is certified CPR, OSHA-10, so COVID-ready, caregiver. Chantel also participated in the possible project, SkillsUSA, at the Boston Bay, B-Club, and Delta. In the fall of 2022, Chantel will be attending the University of Massachusetts and Dartmouth and major in psychology. Chantel has received the following scholarship, UMass Dartmouth Dean Scholarship, as well as the John A. Shelburne Scholarship. Chantel, please come forward.
to our enrollment program at Vocational Community College. Good evening, Madison Park, friends and family. My name is Chantal Martin. I'm a student in the Nursing Assistant Program as well as a participant in the Rock Map Early College Community College. I'm from Early Community College. On May 26, 2022, I graduated with my associate's degree in liberal arts from Bunker Hill Community College. Yes, I earned a degree before my high school graduation. Although it was stressful at times, I was relieved that I did it. I could have not done this without the support of my teachers, nurse my sister, Mr. Shazee, and my advisor, Ms. DeGray. To the students here, I encourage you to take advantage of all resources provided, no matter how stressful it may be. At the end of the day, you got this and you will achieve your goal. Madison Park Technical Vocational High School has changed and positively impacted my life by providing me with many opportunities and skills while earning 5 industrial recognized certificates that I know will help me in my future. I look forward to the next chapter of my life, attending college in the fall with plans of double major in nursing and psychology. I'm extremely excited for the journey awaits me after Madison Park. To my mom and dad, I thank you for your support and your love. Thank you for coming to witness this moment with me. Thank you to my brother and my cousin Richard for being here as well. To Dana, my aunt, I'm so blessed to have you in my life. Thank you for everything. I love you. And to my friends, I love each and every one of you. And a special thank you to Ali and Mohammed for your help and support. Thank you, everyone, for supporting the Class of 2022 and for this recent event.
Now we have camera addition, a computer programming and way of development design students from Madison Park Technical Vocational High School. He enrolled in RockSnap in the spring of his sophomore year. He successfully balanced his academic classes at Bunker Hill Community College and his computer programming and web design vocational responsibilities at Madison Park. While in CPWD, Cameron earned certifications in OSHA 10, HTLM, and CSS. Cameron is also a youth mentor for Soul Home Health. In the fall of 2022, Cameron will be attending the University of Massachusetts, Boston, to study computer science. Cameron has received the following scholarships: John and Abigail Adams Scholarship, as well as the John A. Silver Scholarship. That's welcome to you.
Greetings to all Madison Park Technical Vocational High School students, family, and friends in attendance on this special evening. My name is Cameron Dixon. I'm a student in computer programming and web development. My 4 years here at Madison Park have been an experience from the very start all the way to today. In my freshman year, I almost transferred out of Madison when I first arrived. But then I saw the opportunity to Madison had to offer. I found myself coming into my own skin and becoming the better person I always wished to be. I made friends quickly, excelled in my academics, and began to find new things. In my sophomore year, I changed locations and decided to do a computer programming rather than a try. I caught on rather quickly, and I was on par with my peers in the first month. In sophomore year, I started my journey towards getting my first degree by joining the RockSnap Early College program. Unfortunately, the pandemic came in the spring and somewhat derailed my progress, but I overcame those setbacks and finished the year strong. Let me mention very quickly that all of you here, from students to parents, guardians and teachers, are incredibly strong and have gotten over such a hump as the pandemic was. We should all pat ourselves on the back for finding the strength to get through the pandemic. Like most of us did. Being online throughout the whole school year was difficult. I tried to do my best to keep my spirits up and motivate my peers. Trust me, I knew how draining it was to get up in the morning and find that motivation to get things done. Some days we just wanted to stay in bed. Finally, the new year has come. We are back in person, and that gave me the much needed hope I was looking for. I was finally able to reunite with my friends who I hadn't seen so long. Now, as we jump to today, I'm in my final semester at Bunker Hill, and will be receiving my associate's degree in liberal arts in only 2 months' time. Then in the fall, I will be going to the University of Massachusetts Boston to study computer science. To believe that 4 years ago, I found myself thinking I would accomplish nothing in life. I'm extremely grateful for the opportunity that Madison has given me, all the staff and students who believed in me along my journey. It truly was the help of all of you that allowed me to be successful. And lastly, I do want to give a large thanks to my grandfather, who is sadly not here with us today. But he was one. He was one of the big reasons I keep going, and I know he would be extremely proud of me today. Thank you, everyone, for supporting the class of 2022, and congratulations, graduates.
We have our speaker that will be our city council at large, Ms. Julia Mejia, who is already a speaker in the bio. That's the magic of the speaker.
Standing between me and your diploma, okay? So I am going to make sure that I do not keep you here until tomorrow. Would you like that? Okay. Yes. So, primeramente quiero comenzar saludando a los padres hispanos que están aquí celebrando. Como dominicana que llegó a este país y sabe hablar inglés, logré ser la primera persona en mi familia que se gradúa de high school, ¿ok? All right, y'all, so I'm going to translate. Ok. Basically, I just said that I came to this country. I'm Dominican. I'm an Afro-Latina, which means I claim my black roots because I understand where I come from. And after dropping out of high school, right, because you know what it's like to be out here juggling to make it ends meet. After cleaning offices alongside my mother because she didn't have papers. After being humiliated because we were poor. Working 2 to 3 jobs while I was in high school. I dropped out. But I went back. And let me just tell you this. You can clap for that, yes. Listen, I was almost 19. Actually, no, I was 19, just 20. By the time I graduated high school. was old, but for most of my classmates, right? I didn't have the best clothes, but you know what I had? I had heart and hustle. When I was 9 years old, I learned how to speak up. And let me tell you what we did. I was at the welfare office, translating for my mother. And the case manager had the audacity to be disrespectful and to make my mom feel less than because we were in need. And because I was the official translator for her and anybody else around the way, I didn't tell my mom half the things that she said. Because I didn't want my mom to feel like I did. Because that's the truth. But you know what I did then? When it was my turn to interpret what my mom said, I seized that moment. I let her know about it. Yes. I said, my mother said that you are not like. My mom did not know what I was saying because she was kids to begin with. But I had to let her know, and I have been fighting ever since. And I say this because we, every space that we walk into, we have to fight to get into. Okay? Every space that we occupy, we belong in. Let me tell you this, the only reason why I graduated from high school was because a woman went to my school to share her story about what life was like for her as the first African-American news anchor in the state of Massachusetts, having to deal with the racism. Her name is Liz Walker. Oh, y'all know Liz Walker! And when I say to you, I was still cutting school. I was still working two jobs. But my daughter's counselor one day brought me back to school. And I'm glad that she did because I got to sit in that auditorium. And Liz Walker, just by sharing her story, that one moment interrupted my entire cycle of poverty. Okay? One person can make all of the difference. And that one person is you. Recognize your greatness. So Liz interrupted my entire cycle of poverty. I ended up at MTV. I don't know if MTV's still cool, but it was back 20 years ago. Is MTV still cool? I don't know. But I got a job at MTV. Let me tell you this. I got a job and I became the first urban Latina to be on air covering the news. A Dorchester graduate, someone who had dropped out, who was raised by a single mother that was undocumented, ended up at MTV. Okay? I'm not saying that to show off, but I'm saying that to let you know about your resiliency. And about the things that you do every single day just to go to school. I'm talking about the power that you have to believe in yourself when others won't even give you the time of day. Okay? When you know your power, no one can control you. Do you understand that? Okay. Ended up at MTV, had to fight at MTV. Because every single time I wanted to tell a story about my kids, about the issues that my people were going through, you know what they would always say? What does that have to do with Iowa? And I'm like, what? Why does what the stories that I want to tell, why do they have to relate to Iowa? You know what they said? Because it needed to have national appeal. As though the issues that are facing black and brown young people only matter if it's related to white folks. So I had to let them know about themselves. 10 years later, I was still there. And every single story that I pitched made it all easier. And I say that because when you fight and you walk into a space and you own it, no one can minimize your power. I had a speech that I went completely off of, y'all. But let me stick to the plan before they shut down this mic. Watching you all walking through this room, looking around to your family, your friends, your teachers, and all of the people who cheered you on. It makes me emotional. Because we are only as great as the people who celebrate us, who love on us, who support us, who push us, who hold us accountable to our dreams. Your family and your friends, I want the graduates to clap for them. The last story I'm going to tell is just I only won by one vote. But the second time I ran, I almost popped that ticket. Okay? And yes, but in order for you to understand why that is so important, it was because that vote came from the streets. It was my people who put me in office, and it's only my people who put me here. And that power, that gives you the ability to be fearless. And I say this to you because that's what I want you to be. When you get invited to the table, don't let anyone set terms and conditions. Don't let anybody make you sit in the kitchen. And don't let them just give you a limited menu. You want it all. And you deserve all of it. Y'all can follow me on Instagram. I'm verified too. Julia, F-O-R, for Boston. Follow me and get with me. But the last thing that I'm going to say, I'm going to leave you with, it's like Julia for Boston. The last thing that I'm going to leave you with, and this is something that I want you to remember. Okay? Never, ever, ever leave yourself at the door to make anyone else feel comfortable. Number one. Number two, never water yourself down so that you can be digestible. If they don't like you, let them choke. Is be you, be bold, be brave, and by all means necessary, right? Be unapologetic in the pursuit of your purpose, live your passion, and at the end of the day, recognize your greatness. Thank you.
We want to recognize the National Honor Society. Now, I'd also like to give recognition for these students to please stand. They know who they are. We have a chapter like all other high schools in the country. have recognized the best of the best, that top 10%. The National Honor Society members are chosen for their highest scholastic achievements and by the recommendations of their teachers, so they really have to be good students and have good behavior and academic excellence in hard work. You can recognize these young people by the special collars they are wearing. With the members of the National Honor Society, please stand at your seat, please. Thank you. You may be seated. And now the moment you have all been waiting for. Will the graduation marshal get ready the seniors for the presentation of the diploma? In order for everyone to be heard in the names of the graduates, we're asking you to hold your applause and cheers until all the graduates have received their diplomas. Also, for safety and security reasons, no audience members, and I repeat, no one will be allowed on the floor of the arena for any reason during the presentation of the diploma. I'm going to ask the security personnel and my admin team to make sure that they strictly enforce this policy. Will the seniors from the following programs, automotive technology, collision repair, electricity, carpentry, cosmetology, culinary arts, dental assisting, design and visual arts, present themselves for the diploma? Seniors on my left side, please stand. We're going to go row by row, so the first row stand up, the rest sit back down, please. Been waiting for a whole year for this. Before you come out, have your attention, please. Before you come out, look the name that is stated on your seat. Grab, make sure you sit, you're sitting in the right seat and bring that down with you. Victor Gonzalez. Robbie Gilmer.
vision. J.O. Billings. Benicio Fortes. Jose Fortes. Javon Humphreys. Daniel Mejiacano. Xavier Miller. Anthony Vasquez. Trevor Jeff Lopez. Wesley Alvarez. Omar Yala. Samuel Dixon. Robert Gomez Melo. Kiwan Costa. Juan Lloyd. John Fagan McCoy. Demetrius Bara. Darrell Shears. Angel Tavera. Christian Hidal Alatu. Antonio Zayas. Alexander Lorenzo. Wilma Gonzalez. Catrell Davis. Carlos Petit Rivero. Sasha Ayano. Alexander Pizarro. Yesenia Quintana. Cosmetology. Lena Dutt. Coyle. Ariel Gonzalez. Kiwana Wanda. Willa Quinn. Maesha King. Jamleska Matos. Amira Abdul-Rahim. Kelvin Baez. Michelle Berrios. Zenger Gutierrez Baez. Donation Newsom. Wilby Paul. Ariana Cimero. Central assistant. Ashley Gerald. Dallas Mahoney. Meredith Matos Nova. Iris Ramos Ayala. Gracie
Tutti per il nostro post. Bianchini Sanchez Ortiz. Stephanie Suarez. Lucrece. Joaquin Soto Zabala. Design and Visual Communication. Damon Brown. Michelle Nunes Lissett. Karen Romero. Jamari Williams. From Culinary, Bishana Hopkins. Electricity. Jaden Chambers. Yvette Conway. Manuel Gomes. Christian Gonzalez. Andy Gutierrez Amaya. Emilio Lopez Schott. Rudy Beavish. Ricky Beavish. Elizabeth Placencia. Gregory Richmond. Camilo Siqueira Spinola. Yamari Clayton. Emmanuel Soto. Marquis Taylor. Our next set of students are in the following programs. Listen to the names so you can be proud of the programs we have in Madison Park. Facilities Management, Hospitality Management, Business Technology, ISSN, Plumbing, HVAC, Printing, Medical Assisting, Nursing Assistant, Sheet Metal and Television Production. Seniors, please come forward. Facilities Management, Rashid Chenna, Christopher Clemente Fuentes, Luis Martinez Duran, Jeanette Ortiz, Michael Cora, Noah Rodriguez, Anthony Rosen, Mario Santos, Miles White Foslow, Communications. Francine Miller. Holden Youssef. Health Assistant. Destiny Amaro. Francesca Lillian. Chantal Moody. Carmeline Pena. Eliza Perez. Clary Lee Ruiz. Heating ventilation, air condition. Michael Brooks. Josca de los Santos Santana. Jalen Joseph. Joel Thomas Quinones. Alan Santana. Hospitality Management. Sherwin Baez Peguero. Christopher Taylor. Sandra Contreras Arias. Evander Texas Stanley. Stephanie Levy. Taliani Rodriguez Nick. Nashley Suazo Hernandez. Yarica Tulli. Information Support Network. Christian Aguavivas. Anthony Castillo. Antonis Evans. Kevin Fuentes Lazo. Brian Garcia Santos. Ali Chute. Jan Lassen. Mataki Tejera. Marketing. Simone Fender Smith. Alia Brown Thomas Thompson. Nadine Guzman Brook. Justana Johnson. Aliyah Mohammed. Landra Thomas Thomas Janet. Mia Ice. Tanisha Rager. Damani Swank. Medical Assistant. Ashley Arias Martinez. Bruna Batista. Darlene Cooper. Marta Gomez Martinez. Amanaya
Marco Rivera. Sabatelli, Rosa Faro. Iliani, Luis Guzman. Chicago, Malloy, Glory. Angelin, Elena Tejeda. Michael Ribeiro. Alama Rosario Ramirez. Sasha William Foreman. Fleming. Jordan Abdul Hamid. Jamel Axel. Claudio Bentecourt. Marco Donito Celli. Tyreek Santiago. Andre Smith. Computer Web Study. Cameron Bixman. Faisal Ibrahim. Jerry Mesa. Jordan Shaughnessy. Silva. Rachel Pineda. Brianna Duran.
With a class of 2022, please rise. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Madison Park Technical Vocational High School, we congratulate the class of 2022. Use your hand, right hand, grab your tassel, and move it to the left side. Ladies and gentlemen, on this 10th day of the Lord's year 2023, on behalf of the Boston Public Schools, I now officially declare those of you with diplomas as graduates of Madison Park magnificent Rachel Hoskins. Parents, guardians, family, I know you're excited, but you're going to have to go outside to get those pictures. Students, you can go straight out, straight up, and outside.